Today, we're going to compare Final Cut Pro's brand new auto captions feature added in the Final Cut Pro 11 update to mCaptions AI from Motion VFX. First of all, this video is not sponsored. Motion VFX has absolutely nothing to do with this, but I do need to say that Motion VFX has sponsored previous videos on this channel. And second, the reason I'm comparing Final Cut Pro's auto captions to mCaptions instead of one of the other caption services is because that's what I was using before. Up until Final Cut Pro 11 was released, mCaptions was my go-to for captions and subtitles. So by the end of this video, after comparing the two, I'm going to decide what I'm going to be using going forward and what service I recommend to you. First up is price, and you really can't beat free. If you own Final Cut Pro, the auto captions feature comes completely free in the Final Cut Pro 11 update. That's actually one of the many great features of Final Cut Pro. Every update since Final Cut Pro 10 was released way back in 2011 has been free. This includes a ton of small updates and the big ones like Final Cut Pro 11. mCaptions comes as a part of Motion VFX's design studio plan. This is the only way you can get mCaptions. As of right now, mCaptions is not available as a standalone purchase. The only way to get it is to subscribe to Design Studio. The cost depends on the plan you choose, but it'll cost you anywhere from $17 to $69 per month. I know it sounds expensive, but you get a lot more than just captions. With Design Studio, you basically get every plugin Motion VFX offers. So if you look at what you get with a subscription, provided you need and use a lot of what's included, it's a lot easier to justify the price. But still, you can't beat free. So as far as price goes, Final Cut Pro gets a point here. Next, we have ease of use. Because let's face it, if a tool is useful, but a pain in the butt to use, you're probably not going to use it that much. With Final Cut Pro's auto captions to transcribe your project, all you need to do is select the clips you want to caption and click Transcribe to Captions. The rest is done for you. Final Cut Pro analyzes your audio, transcribes it, times it to the audio in your selected clips, and makes and adds timed closed caption clips above your project. There's no need to isolate your audio tracks, no need to export any files. You just select the clips and click a button. mCaptions is also very easy to use, but does require a few more steps. mCaptions comes as a plugin extension, so you click the little puzzle piece button above your media browser and select mCaptions to open it in its own pop-up window. You then grab your project you want to caption, drag and drop it into this window, and click Analyze. After transcribing your project, you select the Drag from Here button and drag and drop your captions into your timeline. With mCaptions, instead of getting actual caption clips, you get title clips, timed to the audio in your timeline. Having your captions as title clips has its pros and cons, and we'll actually take a look at this later in the video. But for now, as far as ease of use goes, Final Cut Pro gets another point here. Another comparison metric that's also very important is speed. How fast each one of these can transcribe and time the captions in your project. Speed is another big selling feature of Final Cut Pro. The turnaround speed of editing a project in Final Cut Pro is crazy. None of the other NLEs with comparable features and tools even come close. And Final Cut Pro's built-in auto captions is no exception. Down in my timeline, I have a 7-minute project. I'm going to do this in real time. I'll just select my clips and hit the auto captions button. Seconds to transcribe, time, and add captions to my project. That's crazy fast. Let's see how long this takes with mCaptions. I'll grab my project, drag it into my mCaptions window, and click Analyze. Okay, I'm gonna have to speed this up a bit. 1.5 minutes to transcribe my captions. Quite a bit slower, but still, not slow enough to deter me from using it. I actually use this time to take a quick break from editing and stretch my legs. And just for reference, I'm doing this on an M1 Pro MacBook Pro. I'm not sure how much difference that makes. But once again, for speed, that's another point for Final Cut Pro. I know so far Final Cut Pro's auto captions has been better at everything we compared, but stay with me, it's not over yet. Next up is style and formatting for your captions. With Final Cut Pro's built-in auto captions, you can change the text color, or whether to display your captions on top or bottom. But wait, there's more. If you switch to the CEA 608 format, you can move your captions around, as long as you stay within this predefined area. You can italicize and underline your text. You can change the text and background colors, as long as it's one of the 8 color options given to you. And you can change the transparency of your background. You get to choose between 3 different transparency levels. This format even gives you 3 options of animating your captions. You can have them pop on, paint on, or roll up. This is just for the in animation though. You can't animate them out. So as you can see, you're very limited as how you can style your captions in Final Cut Pro. mCaptions, on the other hand, gives you almost unlimited possibilities. First, you start with one of the included presets. They have quite a few to choose from. Just hover over any preset to preview what the captions look like and how they animate on screen. Once you choose the one you like, you can adjust the font, color, position, how they animate on screen, and so much more. There's no comparison here. mCaptions definitely wins the style category. Now that we have our project captioned, let's take a look at what we can do with them. With Final Cut Pro's auto captions, you have a couple options. You can export your captions as a separate file, or if your captions are in the CEA 608 format, you can embed them directly in your export. To export your captions on their own, go up to the menu bar and select File and Export Captions. This exports your captions in your selected format so you can upload them alongside your project. If you use the CEA 608 format, you also have the option to embed your captions right in your video file. This allows your viewer to turn them on or off if they need to. Unfortunately, YouTube doesn't support this, so you still have to manually upload your captions file. You can also burn in your captions right into your video file. This will permanently turn on your captions so they're always visible in the video. You can't turn these off. With mCaptions, you have quite a few different options. The most popular is the drag from here option. You just select it, click this button, and drag it down into your timeline. mCaptions adds your captions as title clips with the animation and formatting you selected. This turns your captions into built-in animated subtitles. If you want a captions file to upload alongside your video, mCaptions comes with an export SRT option. This exports your captions as an SRT file with timecode, so when you upload it to a platform like YouTube, the captions are timed to your video. You can also export your captions as a text file or add them to your library as a separate project. Even though mCaptions doesn't give you an option to embed your captions, since YouTube doesn't support that feature anyways, mCaptions wins the versatility category. Of course, I saved the most important category for last, accuracy. If transcription is not accurate, it's not much good. And I hate to toot my own horn, but my voice is perfect for testing this. I speak with an accent, I don't speak very clearly, I mumble sometimes, and when I get excited, I talk way too fast. Basically, my voice is a nightmare for auto captioning. So what I'm gonna do is pick a part from my last video, transcribe it with both services, and see which one is more accurate. I don't expect either one to be perfect, but let's see which one's better. To test this, I have the intro from one of my previous videos. It's just over 40 seconds long, and has a combination of camera audio, background music, and sound effects. First, let's transcribe this with Final Cut Pro. To make things fair, I'll select all my clips, open the Enhancements dropdown, and select Transcribe to Captions. Just going through these, I can see quite a few mistakes. 8 in total in the 40 second clip, and that's not counting grammar mistakes. Final Cut Pro struggled with sentences. And the most ironic part is the built-in auto captions messed up every time I said Final Cut Pro. You might have better results, but for me, this is way too many mistakes in a short clip. Let's see if mCaptions is any better. I'll open the mCaptions extension, grab my project, and drag it into this window. Let's pick a preset and analyze this clip. Just skimming over these captions look a lot more accurate. I went through my entire 40 second project and there's only one minor mistake. To test this even more, I captioned a full 9.5 minute video, and in the entire video, there's only 3 mistakes. Honestly, with my mumbling, that's impressive. One more thing worth mentioning. Final Cut Pro only supports English for auto captions. mCaptions supports over 90 different languages. This is what Motion VFX claims on their website. I haven't tested this myself. That being said, to me, mCaptions is a clear winner here. Final Cut Pro's auto captions are free, but the formatting options are very limited, You can't use them as subtitles, and most importantly, at least for me, they're not very accurate. Actually, I've tried quite a few other captioning services out there, and I haven't found one even close to being as accurate as mCaptions. I know $17 or $29 per month sounds high, but the way I look at it is like this. I make about 4 to 5 videos per month. If I only used mCaptions from Design Studio, it comes out to just over $4 per video. To me, this is a small price to pay for not having to do them manually or fixing a bunch of mistakes every time. And as icing on the cake, I also get access to over 3,000 motion design elements too. I know this sounds like motion VFX is paying me to say this, but trust me, they're not. I honestly think if you need captions for your video, mCaptions is your best option. Just my opinion. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.